Today I'm going to share some of my favorite tips and tricks for bikepacking. In our last video, my buddy Paul and I bikepacked the Robber's Roost Loop in Sedona, Arizona. And while we were there, we discussed some of our favorite tips and tricks for bikepacking that we wish we'd known when we started. They didn't make it into the final edit, so they're making it into this edit today. Enjoy.
I know a lot of you guys like to learn stuff on my channel, and I like to teach. This is an Enlightened Equipment Enigma quilt. It's not a sleeping bag. It doesn't have a zipper. So it's got the foot box down there, and then all this is open. Now it has these little straps that you can cinch behind you. And the reasoning behind this, it sounds stupid, but it does make a difference. It doesn't have a zipper because zippers are one of the heaviest parts of bags. And realistically, you don't need it because you're laying down on a sleeping bag and crushing most of the insulation. And so you hauled it all the way up there and then you lay on it and it's flat and you're not using it. It can't keep you warm at all. So by running one of these, you don't need to carry the zipper and you can save a lot of weight and it'll store a little bit better. And also a lot of people don't realize that your sleeping pad is for warmth, not for comfort. They insulate you from the ground and the insulation keeps you from transferring body heat to the ground where it just dissipates. So definitely look at the R value of the pads you get. There are lighter backpacking pads than this. But this one has double the R value, so I went with this one instead because it keeps me way warmer, which means I can bring a lighter bag. And then here is my favorite pillow. This is the Climate Cush. So you can use it as a seat and sit on it, but I'm a side sleeper and I just roll it up. And it's got this little ear hole and you just put it on your side of your head and make it the height of your shoulder and then your neck's not craned. And I sleep so much better with this thing. Here's another little tip for you. This is a trash compactor bag and Thermarest makes this little kit and it allows you to hook it up to the nozzle on your sleeping pad. So watch this. You just inflate it and then squeeze it and it transfers it from this bag to my pad. And there's no moisture from your breath inside, so it's never gonna get moldy. You're not lightheaded, and it takes about two of these to fill this whole thing. One of the hardest things for me about bikepacking is picking food and not having too much or too little. I rely on Tailwind a lot. You know I do on all my trips, so I brought some of my Tailwind. For dinner, I've got beef sticks, cheese, and crackers. It's not sexy, but I wanted to go stoveless for this trip. Just because it's a single overnighter, it's warm, I don't need a stove, and I'll be just fine. So if you can find ways to prepare your food without a stove, you don't have to bring a fuel canister, you don't have to bring a cook pot, you don't have to bring the stove, there's less stuff rattling around, that saves you more room for other stuff on your bike. So that's what I did. I don't know if that's gonna be the world's best meal, but it'll give me the energy I need and the calories for tomorrow. A lot of people experience chafing on long days on the bike or multiple day trips. I know it's unpleasant to talk about, but there are some tips you can do for that. Tip number one is to stay clean. It's when you get sweaty and that sweat and salt sticks and stays on your skin, it dries it out and it irritates the skin. If you can use some baby wipes or change your chamois more frequently or stay clean, you will not experience chafing nearly as much. Another tip is to get out of your chamois as fast as possible when you're at camp, if you do use a chamois, and change it for a fresh one. So I bring two. This is my chamois for tomorrow. I love this one. It's the Club Ride Johnson. It's the 1 hour chamois. It's got the thinnest pad. I love it so much, and I use it for way more than an hour. So I'll get here, I'll change into that, and then I'll let my other chamois dry, and if I have a chance to wash it on a multiple day trip, I will do that. But even just rotating it every night and letting it dry really helps avoid chafing and skin irritation. Paul, you got any tips?
My tip is use your buff as a pillowcase.
Ooh, I love that tip. I'm gonna steal that. Great idea. Okay, I'm a little bit jealous of Paul's ground tarp. What is this?
Duck brand screen door shrink wrap kit. Just don't heat it up.
Okay. Wow, that looks like a great little ground cloth to keep your mattress from getting punctured. I have these odor-proof bags. It looks like a Ziploc, but it's not. It's called an OP sack, op sack. This is the lock sack because it zips shut. And these are odor-proof, so bears, chipmunks, rodents, you name it, can't smell your food in here. So I always keep my food in this overnight so that we don't have any critters eating holes in my gear or my sleeping bag or anything like that. So that's a little tip for you. I'll put a link to that in the description below. If you want to get into bikepacking and really get into it, there's a really good book that I have for you. It's about backpacking, but all the principles apply to bikepacking. I'll put a link to it in the description below. But it teaches you that ideally, in a perfect world, you would use everything you brought with you and nothing would be in there that you didn't use except your first aid kit. But you want to wear every single piece of gear. So stuff that keeps me warm in the morning, I can also sleep in, etc. So everything should have multiple uses as well, if possible. A lot of people just load their bike up with all these just-in-case things. And that doesn't work for me because then I just carry way too much stuff. It's way too heavy. I get exhausted. And the most important thing you can take is your brain and your experience. And you could lose every piece of gear and still make it okay if you have experience in the backcountry. So yeah, I'm gonna try and use everything that I brought and have my bags completely empty. We've got camp all set up. Pretty minimal, pretty awesome. So there's a few little tips if you're looking at perfecting your bikepacking setup or backpacking setup or car camping setup. I really like this stuff. I've had it for years and it lasts if you take care of it.